أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. أوكم أولى في Islamic greeting. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Krishna and I'm 7 years old. Dear brothers, the topic today is about Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, who was the last messenger of Allah. There was no prophet come after him. He was son of Abdullah. His mother name was Bibi Amna. He born in the holy city of Mecca in the year 571 AD. He has been breastfeed by the Brahmas Sahaja. The Holy Quran has been revealed on him in the holy month of Ramadan, in the night of Disney, early little Qadr, divine revelation. In his late 30s, Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, took regularly visiting a cave in Mount Hira on the outskirts of Mecca to seek solitude and contemplation. In 610, at the age of 40, Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, returned from one such visit, telling his wife he had either gone mad or become a prophet, for he had been visited by an angel. The initially started Khadija became his first convert. Muhammad, peace be upon him, reported that while on a trance-like state, the angel Gabriel appeared to him and said, "Prop him." But like Moses, Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, was a reluctant prophet. He replied, "I am not a proclaimer." The angel persisted, and the prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, repeatedly resisted until the angel finally overwhelmed Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, and commended him. At the age of 40, Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, received his call to become a prophet. He received the word of God through the angel Gabriel, and the divine message was recorded in the Holy Quran. As Allah says in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Alaq, chapter 96, verses 24. A'udhu billahi min shaitan rajim. Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. خلق الإنسان من علق. اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم. علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. Proclaim, read in the name of your Lord. He created man from a clot of blood. Proclaim, read. Your Lord is the most generous. He teaches by the pen. Teach man what he knew not about his personality and his character. As Allah says in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Qalam, chapter 68, verse 4. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Wa innaka la'ala khuluqin 'azim. And we call them for that
discipline. And you stand it. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ
وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ
برونجو.
And you stand on an exalted standard of character. And just as Allah says in Holy Quran, Surah Al-Ahzab, chapter 33, verse 21. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة من كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. You indeed the messenger of Allah a beautiful pattern of conduct for anyone whose hope is in Allah in the final day, and he engages much in the praise of Allah. Muhammad, peace be upon him, a unique character. The uniqueness of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, is that he was not only a great person in his own time, but he is great for all times, for all people of any race, color, nationality, or geographical location. It is reported in Hadith that Ibn Hisham said that he asked Aisha, Prophet's wife, may Allah be pleased with him.
Tell me.
Tell me about the character of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. She said his character was the Quran. Musnad Ahmad, Hadith number 24139. Some of his attributes. He was kind, compassionate, caring, generous and humble. But he was also strong, brave, eloquent, wise and insightful. He was a great planner, organizer and thinker, yet he was also a man of faith, trust and devotion to Allah. He was involved and active with his family and community, but he did not neglect his parents, fasting and devotion to Allah. Actually, he prayed so much that no one prayed like him. He was exemplary as a teacher, preacher, imam, leader, statesman and judge, commander of the armies, as well as a husband, a father, a grandfather, a businessman, a neighbor and a friend. He was a most humble person. He used to meet with the poor and sit with them. He stopped people standing up for him.
Somehow.
He used to sit wherever there was a place available in an assembly and never sought a prominent or elevated place. The newcomers sometimes would not know who was the Prophet among the people. Muhammad, peace be upon him, in mercy to mankind, was a most merciful person. Allah called him as a mercy to the world, as Allah said in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Anbiya, chapter 21, verse 27. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Wa ma arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil alamin. We sent thee not but as a mercy for all creatures. He was merciful to his family, followers, friends, even enemies. He was merciful to young and old, to humans and to animals. He was the seed of all the prophets, as Allah said in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Ahzab, chapter 33, verse 40. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ما كان محمد أبا عهد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين وكان الله بكل شيء عليما. Muhammad is not the father of any of your men, but he is the messenger of Allah and the seed of the prophets, and Allah has full knowledge of all things. This is Quran Azim. Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Loved his Majesty so much that he would weep out of fear for them. He loved his Ummah with such deep and profound devotion that God remarked on the depth of his love for us in Quran, as Allah said in Holy Quran, Surah Al-Tawbah, chapter 9, verses 28-29. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم فإن تولوا فقل حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم فرجعكم unto you a messenger. Muhammad, peace be upon him, from among yourselves. It grieves him that you should receive any injury or difficulty. He, Muhammad, peace be upon him, is anxious over you to be rightly guided and to repent to God and beg him to pardon and forgive your sins in order. That's why you may enter paradise and be saved from the punishment of the hellfire. For the believers, he is full of piety, kind and merciful. Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, taught us to love God and to obey him. He taught us to be kind to each other, to respect our elders and care for our children. for you taught us that it was better to give than to receive, and that each human life is worthy of respect and dignity. Prophet Muhammad he taught us to love for our brothers and sisters what we love for ourselves. Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, taught us that families and communities are essential. And he pointed out that individual rights, also important, are not more important than a stable moral society. Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, taught us that men and women are equal in the sight of God, and that no one person is better than another except in respect to his or her part and devotion to God. Love of Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, according to following authentic hadith found in Sahih al-Bukhari, narrated Abdullah bin Ishaq, we were with the Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him, and he was holding the hand of Ummah ibn al-Khattab. May Allah be pleased with him. Ummah said to him, O Allah's Messenger, peace and blessings be upon him, you are dearer to me than everything except my own self. Allah's Messenger, peace and blessings be upon him, said, lay by him in whose hand my soul is dear. You will not have complete faith until I am dearer to you than your own self. Then Ummah, may Allah be pleased with him, said, however, Naba Allah, you are dear to me than my own self. He peace and blessing be upon him, then said, now, O Ummah, now you are a believer. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.
Thank you.